Hello, it's Ricardo, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous Beyond, Chapter 4. And with Chapter 4, as mentioned, there came the scanner. But before you can really use the scanner, you've got to do a little bit of work in the control panel of the game and do your key bindings. Because these are several new features, keys have to be assigned to the functions, like tuning or entering scanning mode, switching your HUD over, and the like. So this is going to be a quick video how I've done it. I'm not saying what I've done is right, I'm just saying this is how I've done it. Okay, and we can discuss this in the comments section. If you've got a better way of doing it, hey, let me know, it'd be really good. But hey, keep it positive, you know, let's be positive about this. Change is always frightening to an awful lot of people, and as a result of which, you know, we can either embrace it or play something else. In a way, doing the key bindings is going to be a good way of just making the game feel like your own and setting it up for your own personal preferences. It would have been nice, though, I think, to have had a couple of hints from Frontier Development on this. Like, we suggest, with your default key binding, that this could be an optimal way of assigning some of the functions. Anyway, into controls. Now, we're all familiar with this interface, and this interface we've known right from the beginning of the game. So when you first get in, and I can't show you this at the moment because I've already altered my key bindings, is that they'll be highlighted with a little yellow symbol next to the section that needs to be adjusted. And that's fine. So you can know you need to assign some key bindings to those functions. So, you know, here's the first one. Switch the HUD mode. You've got combat mode and you've got scanning mode. Now I've assigned that to the hash key. And then, you know, discovery, which will open that discovery in the codex, I've assigned to the semicolon. Okay, not ideal, but they're close. I thought, well, that'll do for me. So switching the HUD from scanning to combat, I've assigned to the hash key. It's right there. Boom. Thank you very much. Interested to see what everybody else has assigned it to. Moving down, right the way down to the bottom, we got the full spectrum system scanner. Now, a bit of work is required here. So to enter the scanner, the full spectrum scanner, I'm using F1. Again, might not be ideal, but that's what I'm using, and it seems to work for me. Moving down the camera pitch, I've also assigned this to joystick movements, because I'm using an X52 hot ass. And for zooming into the target, I've got the up and down mouse wheel. Now, sorry guys, I know this is all very PC centric for all the people who are playing consoles out there as well. Also, stepped in and stepped out zoom, I've got the brackets. And then also the tuning, I've got that assigned to I and U. So up and down respectively. Okay. Now mouse as well, the mouse settings. The ability to use the mouse in the scanner mode, I think, is fantastic. And I've set that so that mouse movements will go up, down, left, and right. What you have to look out for is the pitch, right? Now, this basically means up or down, right? So, by default, if you move it up, the cursor's going to go down. So you want to invert that pitch, all right? No dramas. Moving on to the detail surface scanner. Not much to configure there. You've got the toggle front and back view. I've put that on mouse one, and the button mode hold, which means you've got to hold the button down to enable that. So just to go through and recap again, so give you a quick look through this. To enter the mode, F1. Again, I've got the joystick assigned, up, down, left, and right. Again, for the pitch and the yaw. I've also made sure the dead zones are just by default, else it's going to move all over the place. Scrolling down, then, you know, you got the zoom in, zoom out on the mouse buttons. You can step in or zoom in with the brackets. I've set that as well, so I can jump in certain elements to the scanning. Then the tuning, I've got I and O, or I and U, sorry. I being to increase zoom, U to be decrease it, and then the mouse axis, you know, for yaw and pitch, and I've inverted the pitch, so when I move the mouse up, the entire map moves up, and move it down, it moves down. otherwise it's all over the place. That might suit some players, doesn't suit me. Target the current signal I've assigned to mouse 1, so if I want to lock onto a planetary body from the scanner, click on mouse 1. And to exit, there's backspace on the detail service scanner, and to exit the scanner, right, the main scanner, I've used F2. So again, it's not really going to be ideal. I haven't assigned anything yet to the playlist and playing audio logs, but I should do really, because if some of you watched the video yesterday in regards to the codex, it desperately needs some sort of like volume stop start control there in that video. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. That would be great. And leave your comments there as well. So that was a quick look through of what I've done for my key bindings in regards to the scanner and the surface scanner. So that's a discovery scanner and the surface scanner. Those are my key bindings. I'm not sure they're going to stay like that. I may change them as the game progresses, but I just thought I'd share it out and let people make their own decisions as well. And also might come up with something that I have not foreseen, which is more than likely the case, especially these days. So in the comments section, let me know what your key bindings are. If you've got a different way of doing it, we can try it out, see if it works or not. But those are mine. There you go. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I've been Ricardo. This has been my key bindings explanation on how I've bound my keys for the new functionality in regards to the scanner and the detailed surface scanner in Elite Dangerous Beyond Chapter 4. Please check back for more videos in the series. See you soon. And if you haven't already done so, click that like and subscribe button and look for that notification icon. Enjoy it. It's beta for the next couple of weeks.